Hi, welcome back to Italian in 30 Days with Dolce Vita. I am Luca, your Italian teacher, and here with me I have the pleasure to have...
your student of Italian, Marina.
Great. Alright, Marina, sei pronta?
Sì.
Perfetto. Lezione numero 5. Now, remember, last time I taught you how to ask for things.
Yes.
Let's give it a try.
All right. Posso avere una tazza, per favore?
Posso avere una tazza, per favore? O posso avere
questa tazza, per favore?
Certo. Ecco.
Grazie.
Prego.
Posso avere una penna? Questa penna, per favore?
Ecco a te.
Grazie. E posso avere questo libro?
Questo libro.
Libro, per favore.
Perfetto. Now I'm going to teach you another way to ask for things. Very simple, so don't worry about it.
Okay.
We say I or a. I is more formal.
I is informal.
A is formal.
Ah, formal.
I is informal.
Okay.
So, Marina, hai una penna?
Sì.
The answer is sì, ce l'ho.
Ce l'ho.
If you don't have it, you answer no, non ce l'ho.
Okay.
Sì, ce l'ho. No, non ce l'ho. Okay, Marina, hai una penna?
Sì, ce l'ho. Ah.
Grazie. Hai una tazza?
Sì, ce l'ho.
Grazie. Hai un libro?
Sì, ce l'ho.
Hai un bicchiere d'acqua?
No, non ce l'ho.
Hai un caffè?
No, non ce l'ho.
Hai una gomma?
No, non ce l'ho.
Perfetto. Now, if Marina were the queen, I wouldn't say I would say a, because
more
I would be more formal.
Okay, I see.
Okay. I mean, sometimes if you're a tourist and you go to a shop, usually you use the formal way.
Mm.
You don't have to because you're a tourist, so it doesn't matter.
But it's better nowadays.
And we Italians were very friendly, so it doesn't really matter. But if you want to be formal, you say, ha una tazza, per favore? Ha una penna? Ha un libro?
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
sì. Yeah.
Perfect.
It's easy. So,
let's skip and go to a new topic.
Okay.
Which is the numbers from 1 to 10.
Mm-hmm.
I numeri da 1 a 10. Alright,
yeah.
Let's start. 1.
1.
2.
2.
3.
3.
4.
4.
5.
5.
6.
6.
7.
7.
8.
8.
9.
9.
10.
10.
Ok, ripetiamo. Let's repeat. 1.
2.
3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now that we know the numbers, we can maybe ask for the price. So we look at something and we ask, how much is it?
Mm-hmm.
How do we do that?
Is it that cheap in Italy? Everything costs just up to 10 euros?
Well, you know, we'll learn numbers from 11 to 1 million later. But as of now, let's concentrate.
Yeah, let's go shopping for souvenirs.
Exactly.
Good
one. So, very easy. If we're asking about one thing, singular, we say, quanto costa?
Mm-hmm.
How much is it? And if we ask for more things, we say, quanto costano? How much are they?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's easy.
Shall we give it a try?
Yeah.
With these things? Marina, quanto costa questa tazza?
Oh, questa tazza? And the answer is costa?
Costa.
Questa tazza costa 2 euro.
That's quite expensive.
What? Expensive?
No, I'm kidding. Ok, e quanto costa questa penna?
Questa penna costa 10 euro.
It's a good pen. Sì.
Yeah,
va bene. Ok. Marina, quanto costano questa tazza e questo libro?
Can I say just the verb? They cost,
sì,
costano.
Sì, costano.
Costano 10 e 10 euro.
No, insieme, together.
Ok, costano 10 euro.
10 euro. Good price, buon prezzo. Perfect, so very easy.
Yeah,
quanto
sì,
costa? Quanto costano?
Quanto costa? Quanto costa? Mm-hmm. Quanto okay. costano?
Quanto costa?
Alright.
Alright, cool. So. Okay, Marina, now we take a look at nouns, I nomi. Okay?
Yes.
Now, we have in Italian, nouns are either masculine or feminine.
Yeah.
And now we're gonna see the patterns that nouns follow when we do the plural. Mm-hmm. So we have three most common patterns, which are, first one, maschile, masculine, the singular ends in o, which means that the plural will end in e. O, e. Feminine, when the singular feminine ends in a, the plural will end in e. A, e. And then we have a third pattern, which is both masculine and feminine, and it ends in e. Well, the plural will end in e. E, e. Now, if this is confusing a little bit, don't worry, because now we're gonna take a look at some examples, and it will
practice.
Be very...
O, e, a, e. E-I.
Perfect.
I'll try to remember.
Okay, so let's take a look at examples. Of course, examples from singular to plural. Esempi dal singolare al plurale. First category, we said masculine singular that ends in O. An example is table, which is tavolo. Tavolo will become, in the plural, tavoli. Another word is child is bambino, and the plural is bambini. And then dish in Italian is piatto, the plural will be piatti. Okay, so tavolo, tavoli, bambino, bambini, piatto, piatti. Let's take a look at the category which ends in A, the singular feminine. Word in Italian is parola. Now the plural would be parole. Child again, but this time feminine, bambina.
A the, girl.
Exactly. The plural would be bambine.
Mm-hmm.
And fork, which is forchetta. The plural will be forchette. So as you see, it's very easy. Third category, which is both masculine and feminine, ends in E. Now, the masculine, for instance, father is padre. The plural will end in E, padri. Tooth, which is dente.
Denti.
Denti, glass.
Bicchiere, bicchieri.
Bicchieri, perfect. And then again, third category, but the feminine. Mother is madre. And will become madri. Key is chiave, and it will become chiavi. Argument is lite, and will become liti. Okay, Marina? Is this facile?
Sì.
Okay, now let's practice. Pratichiamo. Coltello, which is knife. Plural.
It's masculine, coltello, coltelli.
O, I, esatto. Casa.
Casa is feminine, casa, case.
Esatto, casa is house. Cane. Cane is dog.
Well, I don't know which gender it has, but if it ends with E, then it becomes I, cane, cani.
Esatto, cane, cane.
Torre.
Torre is tower.
Torre.
Torre. Gatto is cat.
Gatti. Gatti.
Gatto, gatti. And zia is aunt.
Zia, zie.
Zie. Esatto. So as you can see, it's pretty much.
Yeah, you just need to practice to.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's pretty much. It's pretty much it.
All right.
So, grazie Marina.
Grazie Luca.
E noi ci vediamo alla prossima lezione numero 6. Ciao.
Ciao.